Sam Worthington is still the lovable lad from Perth, even with his starring roles in Hollywood blockbusters like Terminator Salvation, Clash of the Titans, and, of course, Avatar.
Outstanding.
But it's his role in Under the Banner of Heaven, which is unlike anything we've seen before. Set in 1984, it tells the true story of a small Mormon community rocked by the brutal murder of a young mother and her baby.
The evidence points to things and to beliefs that I have only ever heard whisperings about.
Congratulations on an absolutely mesmerising performance in this series.
Oh, that's very kind, Lisa. Thank you.
How do you approach a story, though, Sam, when you know that there are so many people who are still affected by this crime who are still alive? Does that change in any way your preparation or how you approach the role?
Yeah, it does, absolutely. I think you, from day one, you know, once the camera starts rolling, you know you've got a responsibility to tell it right and that it isn't just a procedural. You know, this was never a simple whodunit. It's more a why did this happen, like a why done it, I suppose, or a how did it happen, because this was such a devoted and pious and loving community and family. And then the event itself is so horrific. And so hopefully across the whole series, we get to understand how these guys kind of ended up doing something so tragic and despicable.
Do you think being a dad gave you an extra perspective on all of this?
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, it hits home. This is a story about, you know, a family that kind of lost their way. And so it kind of strengthens your own family because you're seeing the perils and the problems that they had. And I would come home and give my kids a loving kiss because you never want anything to happen, you know, unfortunate, like what happened to poor Brenda.
We saw you and Lara at the premiere. Is she also a bit of a true crime lover as well?
Lara likes stuff with Liam Neeson. She likes good action movies.
So is that the deal now? That's Lara nudging you to do more movies with Liam Neeson?
Luckily, Liam Neeson played my dad in some movies years ago, the Clash movies. But she's trying to get me to do action, more action stuff, but I said, I'm getting old now. My legs are giving away. I'm an old man. I can't be running around like that anymore.
Under the Banner of Heaven boasts a cast including rising star Daisy Edgar-Jones and everyone's favourite good guy, Andrew Garfield.
Heavenly Father, we ask that we might be instruments in thy hand to fix what we find broken. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Tell us something about him that makes us think he's not 100% perfect.
Look, I did Hacksaw Ridge with Andrew, so I've known him a long time, and he was one of the main reasons I wanted to jump on this because he raises the bar. But I found out recently that he's into knitting. So that's his dirty, dark secret, is that he knits all the time. It's quite incredible.
Doesn't it just make him an even gooder guy?
It makes him even more. Yeah, you cringe even more. You hate him even more. Knitting some baby booties. Yeah.
It's a huge year for Sam, with December 16th confirmed as the date we'll finally get to see the long-awaited Avatar sequel. 13 years is a long time. How has that wait been for you?
Well, yeah, you're right. I was, what, 30 when I did the first one of Jake in a wheelchair. And then I think, you know, I'm going to be pushing 50 by the time the others are coming out. I think I'm going to end up in a wheelchair by the time I do Avatar 5, literally.
Yeah, I think I did the maths. You're going to be 84 at this rate when the last one comes out.
Yeah, Stephen Lang will be 120. But, you know, I'm humbled to be part of that family. It's, you know, Jim's a very close friend. He's changed my life many times over. And, you know, I'm a small cog in such a big creative team, and it's going to be a privilege to kind of give this to the world.
Zoe Saldana said that she was moved to tears with the small part that she saw. Have you got to see it yet?
I think she had the 3D goggles on wrong, probably. That's what made her eyes water, because that keeps getting me in trouble. Everyone keeps asking that question. I've seen a lot of it with Jim, and you got to understand, Jim's always pushing the envelope. And he's definitely doing that with these sequels.
I know one thing. Wherever we go, this family is our fortress.
You are living in the States these days. Do you miss much about home in Australia?
Yeah, miss Bubble O'Bill. Miss Chiquitos.
Yeah.
I miss spearmint milk, things like that. Yeah, simple things. Yeah.
Do you get Vegemite shipped over and Tim Tams?
Yeah, we get the Tim Tams. We do get them, yeah. We don't get rainbow paddle pops. That's what we don't get.
I have a quote here from Lara that says,
He's more normal than me. He's the guy from Perth who drinks milk before he goes to bed.
Yeah.
Is this true?
Yeah. Yeah, I like milk.
And are you the more normal of the two of you?
My wife's beautiful and down to earth, and you know, you have to tell her to unpack the dishwasher every now and then, but it's like she kind of refuses. But no, she's, you know, Lara's what you see is what you get. You know, she keeps everybody sane in our family.
Oh, well, it's good to know that life is so good for you over there in the States. Congratulations, and thanks so much for joining us on the project.
Thanks for your time. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
I hope you get some deals like advertising the Buffalo Bill
and
the paddle
box. It's kind of a crowdfunding campaign to get some Buffalo Bills over there to him.
I can't believe they're not American. I thought it was like a Texas gunslinger. I feel like that's what Buffalo Bill was.
I think it's more like a bushranger vibe, I suppose.
Yeah.
just quickly, I cannot tell you how powerful Sam Worthington's performance is in this. Yeah. The moment he appears on the screen just comes alive, and it is such a powerful story. It is called Under the Banner of Heaven, and it premieres Wednesday, June 8th on Disney+.